Blessed people of God, would like to welcome you to our online service. And we do believe that the Lord has kept you and he has protected and taken care of you. Shall we begin with a word of prayer? Merciful Father, the author and master of our lives, we want to thank you for this far. And Lord, it is our prayer that you begin with us, and at the end we shall be called the blessed of the Lord. As we sing for you, as we hear your word, we pray that we may be guided of the Holy Spirit. And that is our prayer in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Brothers and sisters, shall we begin with the Lord's Prayer? Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours now and forevermore. Amen. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, We stand with Christians throughout the world to affirm our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On that day he rose again. He is ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever wilt be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have
Let's pray for our nation and the church all together. Almighty God, you rule all nations and elect them according to your will, and all the leaders of our country, we commit them before thee, so that they may always use the authority that you have given to them for the peace of the world and the benefit and honor and development of our nation. Therefore, Lord, we pray that you may continue to guide them so that even your holy church may experience transformation, growth through the leadership and the peace of our nation, Kenya. And that is our prayer in Jesus' mighty name. Shall we continue to pray for the church? Almighty and eternal God, the only source of power, grant our bishops, very particular Bishop Charles, the diocesan bishop, and all the clergy of this diocese, and all the people of our diocese, that your health-giving spirit of grace, in order that they may truly please you, pour out them the continued dew of your blessings. Grant this for the sake of your advocate and mediator, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. At this juncture, I ask of you to go before the Lord and petition unto him your needs and desires, because he's our Father, and he's going to bless us, and he's going to meet us to our very point of needs, because he knows us more than we know ourselves. Shall we end the intercessory prayer with the prayer of Saint Chrysostom? Almighty God, by your grace we have come together at this time to bring our united prayers to you. And you have promised by your Son Jesus Christ that where two or three are gathered in his name, he will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petition as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the world to come life everlasting, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Jesus, keep me near the cross, there a precious fountain, free to all a living stream flows from Calvary's mountain. In the cross, in the cross, be my glory ever, till my wretched soul shall find rest beyond the river. Near the cross, a trembling soul,
till my rapture Praise the name of the Lord. I greet you all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Agatha Kariuki and I'm born again. And I would like to give this opportunity, take this opportunity to thank our Reverend Grace Gadogo for giving me this opportunity to minister the word of God this morning. Our sermon is based on the book of Numbers 32. And because for the interest of time, I'm going to be reading just Numbers 32, 20 to 23, and it says, "And Moses said unto them, If you will do this thing, if you will go armed before the Lord to war, and I will go all of you armed over Jordan before the Lord until he has driven out his enemies from before him, and the land be subdued before the Lord, then afterward ye shall return and be guiltless before the Lord and before Israel, and this land shall be your possession before the Lord. 23. But if you will not do so, behold, you have sinned against the Lord, and be sure your sin will find you out. And be sure your sin will find you out." If I was to give a title to the sermon or the scripture that I've just read, I would call it "The Testimony of Our Conscience." The testimony of our conscience. What is conscience? Conscience is the ability to know or to discern right from wrong. There is the testimony of our conscience and there is the testimony of God. The testimony of God is greater than our testimony. When Jesus Christ was baptized in River Jordan, God spoke from heaven and said, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." That was the testimony of God about Jesus. A brief background about the scripture that we've just read. The children of the tribe of Reuben and the tribe of Gad, being pastoralists, before they crossed over the other side of Jordan, identified good land and pasture for their land. They were like the Maasai people in Kenya. They were pastoralists. And they went to Moses, the servant of God, and Eleazar the priest, and the princes of the congregation, and they said unto them, "If we have found favor in your sight, allow us to inherit this land east of Jordan." And Moses didn't take that very well, because there was much land to be possessed, and with possession of the promised land, they had to fight battles, God helping them and God leading them to the battle to possess the promised land. And so they continued to plead with Moses and said, "After we have built folds for our cattle, and after we have built houses for our children and our wives, we are going to proceed with you to the other side of Jordan, and we are going to engage in battle until all the rest of the remaining tribes of Israel would possess the land." And this, they came into an agreement. And so Moses, that's why Moses said, again in verse 23, "But if you will not do so, behold, you have sinned against the Lord, and be sure your sin will find you out." Our title today is "The Testimony of Our Conscience." We are living in times that are troublous. We are living in times that are difficult. And what are we to do when we hear looming threats of corona and looming threats of a locust invasion in our country, Kenya, and even very hard political times ahead of us, ahead of the 2022 election? What are we to do as Christians? Judgment must begin in the house of God. We must stop pointing fingers at others and get back to our closet and say, "It is I, Lord, in need of repentance. It is I, Lord, in need to walk with a clear, pure conscience so that my integrity can speak, our integrity can speak for us in latter times. The children of Nineveh, upon the preaching of Jonah, were told there will be judgment, but they went to their closet and they repented. And when they repented, God turned the judgment and there was revival. And that can happen to us even in Kenya. We don't have to wait for the second wave of Corona. The word of God, as I conclude, says, repent ye therefore and be converted, when the times of refreshing will come from the presence of the Lord. So we must go back, if we are not already in our closet, and stay in our closet and bring repentance before God. Bring repentance on behalf of our churches, of our family, and of our nation. And that is called identification repentance, so that God may have mercy upon us. And instead of allowing the second wave of Corona to come over to our nation, Kenya, we will experience revival. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen.
Right. I do believe that you've been blessed by the word. And now it is our opportunity and our privilege to give unto the work of the Lord. Therefore, brothers and sisters, through the pay bill that is on the screen and also the M-Pesa number, you can do your tithing, your offertory, thanksgiving, and other forms of giving using those numbers on your screen. And I do believe that the Lord is going to bless you. Shall we pray for the offertory and other forms of giving that has been given? Shall we? We want to thank you, Lord, for whom you are in our lives. And also we want to thank you because you've given us the energy and the zeal to work. Because you've said, if we don't work, we should not eat. And because of that, Lord, you have given us so much that we feel indebted to you. And how we pray that you receive all the tithe that has been given and other forms of giving. The Lord, you may set them apart, consecrate them, Lord, so that they may be used for the extension of your kingdom. Bless your people, and Lord, as they go out, as they come in, they will be blessed of you. Meet them to the very point of your needs. In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Shall we have our closing prayers? Almighty God and everlasting King, we come to the end of our service, and we want to say thank you so many times, because we cannot do anything without you. You are a source of refuge and a source of and a fortress. And Lord, we want to thank you for the way you've been encouraging us, also inspiring us through your word. We thank you for giving us an opportunity to sit under your feet. Now, Lord, as we embark on our daily basis activities, Lord, we pray that you may guide us, you may walk with us and order our steps. And this is our prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.